Hello from the Disneyland Esplanade. I am here in front of California Adventure Park. Today is opening day of Food and Wine Festival, so there's a lot of fun to be had inside today. I'm gonna take you inside with me. We're gonna try some of the new foods for the festival. We're gonna check out the entertainment, hopefully see Chef Goofy, go on a couple themed, well, actually one themed ride for the event. There's just a lot of fun happening today. I love Food and Wine Festival. So let's head on inside and start our day together. Okay, the first thing we're doing is we are rope dropping Soarin Over California, which for Food and Wine Festival, the ride is typically Soarin around the world. And for Food and Wine, they switch it back to the original Soarin Over California. And they do something really fun at the end if you're one of like the first groups to get on. So hopefully we're gonna be one of those, and I'll show you what it is. We rope dropped specifically for this reason, because none of the other stuff for Food and Wine starts till like 10:30, 11. But let's go see if we can get that special little thing. All right, we are heading into Soarin Over California. I love this ride. Tell me in the comments below, do you prefer Soarin around the world or Soarin Over California? I have my personal preference, and I'll tell you at the end. Okay, moment of truth. This is what we rope dropped for. Yes! Woo! We got it! Thank you! We got our orange for Soarin Over California, Soarin Over the Orange Groves. Okay, I'm here with my friends, and this is what we rope dropped for, was to get our orange after riding Soarin Over California. We literally have nothing to do now for a few hours. We came for this reason, so yay, we got him! Orange cheers!
Cheers!
Woo! Okay, we are in line over at Kingswell over in Buena Vista Street to get our Sip and Savor Pass, because there are different places you can purchase it from. It's not just the booth over by the waterfall area in DCA. You can go to different shops. I will list them below, but we're in Kingswell grabbing ours right now. Okay, so here are the Sip and Savor Pass, and this is the tasting passport. It kind of gives you an idea of where things are. The Sip and Savor Pass, like I said, you can purchase those at different locations. I will go ahead and put down below the price of everything, but we always go for this. It just makes it easier. And yeah, you just take it to each booth and scan and pay for it this way. Okay, the next thing I'm gonna show you, it's not open or it's not happening right this second, is inside Hollywoodland. This is the Confection, it's a bit of a tongue twister, Confection Purrfection with the Super Kitties from Disney Junior. So this was formerly Alice's Wonderland Bakery. It's an activity that the kids can do specifically for Food and Wine. And I don't know what they'll be decorating this time because it's a little bit different, but it's where they decorate either like a cupcake or a cookie or something like that. There are certain show times. It starts more in the afternoon. I think the first show time is 1:30. But I'm gonna show you what it is like and give you a tip. If you do wanna do this with your kids, you've gotta follow this tip. Otherwise, there's a good chance you won't be able to do it. So let's head inside and I'll show you the stage area. Okay, so we're heading into Hollywood Studios. There are some of the marketplace food booths over here as well. But over here on this stage area, this is where you will find, oh, there's a band playing right now. But later today at 1:30, this is the first show, and this is where it will be. So right along this line, or this line of umbrellas here, is usually where they will start the lineup, and there will be like a little sign. You need to be in this line, I would say minimum 30 minutes, but to be even safer, I would say 45 minutes before showtime to make sure that your child gets to participate in it, because they do have to cut it off. There's only a certain number of kids they can do for each show. So if you're wanting to do this, I would say 45 minutes to be safe, get in the line. You'll see a sign right here. There'll be cast members, you can talk to them, and then they will sign your child up for the show. So I'll come back later today when it's happening to give you an idea of what it's like. Okay, right over here too, this is the craft area. So you'll find different crafts throughout the day. It's usually like a chef's hat and stuff they get to color. That's this area right here by the stage. Okay, if you wanna do the Super Kitties, you have to check in. Check-in is around the corner over here. So it's that line right back there. So definitely you wanna get here a little bit early to make sure that your child can do it. I believe it's ages 3 to 11 that can participate.
That was awesome. All right, I know you're getting ready to decorate some cupcakes. But first, we gotta warm up our cupcake decorating muscles a little bit. You know, we're
birthday cake, you and our new friends can start on the cupcakes.
Positively, we're on it.
Pause in, Super Kitties. We're brave. We're smart. We're strong.
We're kind.
Super Kitties, go!
Meow is right! All right, Junior Chefs, you heard the Super Kitties. It is time to save the day with a little creativity. Are you ready to make some cupcakes? Let me hear you say meow! All right, but first, we got to level up with some cupcake decorating kits. You know what we call them around here? Oh. Kitty kits. Yeah, that's right. They've got cupcakes. They've got sprinkles. They've got frosting. They've got everything you need. So as soon as you get your kitty kit, go ahead and open it up and start decorating.
Okay, so it's still early. It's about 9 o'clock. The festival booths don't open until 10:30. That's what time the line opens up to. But here's a huge tip for you, and not everybody realizes this. There are signs around, but what you can do, so if you want to order things from different booths, usually the line to order is kind of long. If you wait in one of those lines to order one time, you can order everything that you want at that one booth. So it'll save you from having to skip around to the other booths and stand in the ordering line each time. Just go in line for at one booth, order everything you want, and then you have your receipt that you take to each booth throughout the day with your items on it, and just go into the pickup line. So it saves a ton of time. It's a huge tip. I've shared that before on my Instagram, and people don't realize that you can actually do that. So take advantage of that. Know what you're gonna order for the day and order everything at the first booth that you go to save you time waiting in long lines later in the day. So you're gonna wait for these booths to open and then get some foods. And this is not open yet, but this is one of the booths. This is like the main booth to purchase your Sip and Savor at. It's right over here. We're across from the Grizzly River Rapids. Like I said, there's other places to purchase, but if you're around this area, you can purchase right here. Okay, if you want to see the menu, you can go ahead and scan this QR code. If you have another phone handy, check out the menu items for food and wine. Okay, we are here at the Obelisk, I believe it's called. This is where the Jammin' Chefs play. This is a really cute show. They have a few show times throughout the day. Great for kids, great for adults too. It's really fun. They jam out on like pots and pans. So you can catch that right over here. Okay, so that was the Jammin' Chefs. It's a very cute show.
It happens
a few times throughout the day, so make sure you catch that. Next, I'm gonna go over to the Kayla's Cake, which is one of the little carts that they have here at DCA, like kind of along the walking mat. I'll show it to you in a second. But they were very kind. They reached out. They wanted to collab together. So I'm gonna go grab a bunch of their exclusive macarons for Food and Wine Festival inside here. So I'm gonna go grab those, show them to you, and we're gonna try them out. So let's head over. Besides the festival marketplace booths, there's also all these fun little carts throughout like the walking paths of DCA. This one's really cute. Mom and Pop Shop. They're all natural and organic popsicles. There's Kayla's Cakes down the way, which I'm gonna take you guys to see in a little bit. Just some cute little carts, but this one's fun. I like this. Okay, there's a lot of festival entertainment that happens throughout the day. Here's kind of a general rundown. You can pause here, or you can scan that QR code. But lots of really cool things to see here throughout the festival. Okay, so if you're walking down DCA, this is Kayla's Cakes right here. Lots of yummy macarons. I'll show you in just a second. All right, look at all these yummy macarons from the Kayla's Cake. So good. I can't wait to try these out. All right, let's go try some macarons. Okay, so I have to eat this one first because it is kind of sunny out, but this is the macaron ice cream sandwich. This is the cookies and cream. Looks amazing. I have a feeling I'm gonna have like a bright blue mouth when I'm done, but it looks really good. So we're gonna dig into this one first. Oh, that is super yummy. Hey, just tried all the flavors of the Kayla's Cakes macarons. This one was really good. This is the s'mores one. That one was delicious. There's actually a number of really good ones. There are four that are exclusive for the festival. The s'mores and the Oreo one that I got are, you can get them anytime downtown Disney. Covered in like chocolate. But that one was really good. Definitely check them out. They have a whole cart full of yummy macarons. The ice cream was super good. I really enjoyed that one. And yeah, check them out. All right, Festival Beer Garden back here in Paradise Gardens area. Food and wine. You got Goofy Sky School right up there. Let's take you guys, check it out. This is the queue here. So pretty back here. Okay, we are now going to try some of the festival foods. Just been busy all morning doing other stuff, but we're gonna go try out some of the foods. I'm getting a drink first, so let's check it out. All right, this is what we're about to try, the Huckleberry Citrus Cooler. Got it right here, let's test it out. Okay, so this is the Huckleberry iced tea thing. It's got huckleberry syrup, it's got lemon and orange juice, it's got black tea, non-alcoholic. Let's see. Oh, that's really good. This tastes like something you would want to be sipping like by a pool. Tastes very, it's really good. Oh, I would definitely recommend this. Good for kids too, like I said, non-alcoholic. This is really delicious. Check this one out for sure. Okay, the next item I have here are the Impossible Chicken Parm Bites. They look really good. I'm gonna try it out. Try and get a little bit of everything in this bite here. Oh, they're like chicken nuggets. It tastes just like chicken parm, but it's not, it's impossible chicken. This is super good. I actually really like this. Okay, one more food item to try. Okay, next we have the Baja style fish taco. So it's not actually fish, it's fake fish. But it actually looks really good. So I'm gonna try this one next. See if it can compete with the chicken parm. That is really good. I actually really like that too. If you didn't tell me that this was not real fish, I don't think I would know. This is delicious. I would recommend this one too. All right, and that is all from me for opening day of Food and Wine Festival here at California Adventure Park. I gotta head out, but I hope you found something helpful in there. I hope you enjoyed it. There is so much to check out here at the festival with the live entertainment, the shows, the food, the wine, the drinks. So if you come, have a great time, and I'll see you guys in my next video.